They assume too much of you. You see someone for minutes, maybe hours if you have the same classes, and they think they can recognize when something's wrong. You don't even have a chance to respond, and they think they know what is best for you, as if they know what you're feeling. I don't know why it bothered me so much. I don't even know why it started.
Like I said, I'm sorry, I wasn't looking where it was going, I guess. Hey, you okay? Look like something's, I don't know, off? I mean, I was gonna ask you again, but I never got the chance, and just look, something's wrong. Look, I get it, sometimes people are just tired, but it's more than that, isn't it? You okay?
You start noticing the things that aren't really there. How your smile falls in a certain way, or how sunken your eyes look compared to the rest of your face. You don't notice the subtle nuances about yourself, because to you they're just that. But there wasn't anything out of the ordinary. Nothing that indicated more than sleep deprivation or a few nights of stress. At least not from what I could see.
Have the entire week to do this project, so I really don't want you to progress in it. Oh, and that reminds me, you can do your polyatomic ion packet now in class. I really don't care what you do afterwards. You have no homework. You can go now. See you next week. Remember your project. Erick.
I found this next to your desk. Is everything okay? Anything going on at home?
There's nothing.
I just worry for you. Not because your grades are dropping or anything in my class, but I'm worried.
You shouldn't be.
Cheer up, asshole.
Two new messages.
Hi, Aaron. It's Mom. I was just calling to let you know that your father and I are staying in Bermuda for 2 more days. Oh, and I put some money in your car just in case you want to buy some pizza or takeout. We miss you. Remember to brush your teeth. Love you. Bye.
Aaron, it's Dad. You teacher called last night, but I couldn't pick up the phone. She left a message and she sounded really worried about you. Said that you were acting strange in class, dazing off and looking like there's something wrong. We'll talk more about this when your mother and I get home, but please don't do anything reckless. Yeah?
I tried to find what they saw in me. I picked apart my body, saw beneath every layer, put myself into the shoes of the teachers and students and friends who thought there was something wrong. I couldn't see what they saw. I felt like pulling my eyes from their sockets, like forcing my nails from my fingers, like ripping every piece of skin from my face, one piece for every time someone asked if there was something wrong with me. Did they want to see something wrong with me?
Oh, hey, I was calling you right now, actually. It's just, you know, you agreed on 7, and it's 7:15. Not that there's anything wrong with you. Being late, I mean. I guess I thought you just forgot about the project.
I was jogging. I didn't forget.
That's good. So, you gonna knock this thing out, or what? It's not my place to comment all that much on what's going on in your life and stuff. But I've seen how you've been acting lately. I know you haven't been feeling fine. I've noticed, but...
I mean, don't get me wrong, I've been trying to do since March. I try every day you can, but... it just seems to be hard nowadays.
Just know you have a friend who really cares about you.
Sunny. Yesterday my life was filled with rain. Sunny, you smiled at me and really eased the pain. Now the dark days are done and the bright days are here. My sunny one shines so sincere. Sunny one so true, I love you. Sunny, thank you for the sunshine bouquet. Sunny, thank you for the love you've brought my way.